Hey folks, good morning and welcome to Smile Jamaica. It's morning time. It is Wednesday. That's why myself and the great Empress Camila here. And it is November 8th. 2 days before the greatest day ever in the history of life. Because my birthday is Friday. It's a very simple thing. Number one month. And on the 10th of November. Public holiday. Remember me. Only day if you have to go out the road on November the 10th. Just sit down at home and don't do anything. Public holiday. Ciao. We welcome our friends at onespotmedia.com, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat at SmileJamTVJ, and also on televisionjamaica.com. Great to have you with us this morning. Time to get up because you have so many things to do, including watching us.
Good morning, Mr. Bell.
What up?
I'm alive. Good morning, Jamaica. Good morning, as Neville said, to all our friends across the globe tuning in. It's an honor to be here with you. We give thanks that you are alive, that you're well, that you're kicking, that you're up, that you're smiling, and you're living, and you're giving. And it's not a public holiday, children, on Friday, because Uncle Neville said it's his birthday. Not everything you hear on the television is fact or truth.
what you do when you want people to, we call it a petition.
A petition.
So I can send a petition to the office of the Prime Minister.
Well, you can, but as you can see with what's happening now with the cockpit country petition, and the Prime Minister was supposed to respond within 30 days, and some people are very upset because they haven't gotten a response. So you may not want to start the petition.
A gentleman stopped me yesterday and said he started a petition.
For?
I cannot remember is what he said it was for.
I was
coming out of Marketplace yesterday, and I stopped so he couldn't go by, and he touched it, and he said he wanted to say something, and I said, yeah. And he said he started a petition. Oh!
You remember. So,
but no, I remember now. He says August 6th, a national holiday. Isn't it, though? August 6th is our Independence Day. Isn't it a national holiday?
Isn't it? Yeah.
But that's what he said.
Okay. Well, that one...
No. August 1 is a national holiday also? Emancipation Day?
It is a holiday.
I was thinking about it because if it falls on a Sunday, we celebrate like the Monday, don't Kadeen? Mm-hmm. So I'm wondering if he was saying the day itself, the date?
Yeah.
That whichever day it
but
falls.
But weekends
on.
Are never really a holiday.
No,
you can't. No. You don't have a holiday.
But
on
I'm
a
sure
weekend.
That's what he said. He says August 6th. He said he sent the petition, so we will hear more about it. So sorry, sir, that I don't remember. But I'm sure that's what he said. He said August 6th must be a national holiday.
You know,
but it is.
You know the truth about retaining information is that if it really was relevant to you and you found it really important, then you would have remembered.
No, I remember everything, actually. I have a good memory.
You do?
I actually have a very good memory.
Okay.
In Toronto, when they meet you, mm-hmm. and they say, this is Empress. They say, hi, Empress. Mm-hmm. In Jamaica, I say, this is Empress. They say, hi, how you doing? And then when I reach the door, I say, What's your name again? But apparently when you call the name, it says, hi, Empress.
You remember,
which is what I was told.
Right.
But even in Jamaica, we still do it. So somebody say, meet Empress. And I say, hi, how you do?
Mm-hmm.
And I don't call your name.
Yeah, yeah.
And then about 10 minutes later, I say, what's your name again?
Yeah. But you know what I don't like? When people come up to you and they say, you remember me? I'm going to say, yeah. Where you remember me from? Listen to me.
But you must lie. If you don't remember them, say no.
No, so, but I do remember.
So
but then why are you probing so much? If I say I remember, then probing me means
people,
what?
People do it that way. The other thing they
people
do is say, you remember me? I remember me and I said, not really. You don't remember me? So I said, no. Me can't believe. So you know why me lie and just say yes. And then when they say where, I said, me. Anyway, I will move quick because I have 472 birthdays.
Whoa! Okay.
So on today's show, we hit the streets and get the perspective of young Jamaicans and our country's main issues. That's interesting.
And still, yes, and still on our country's issues, we discuss the role as we citizens, we discuss the role that we citizens must play to stop crime.
Yep, been saying that for a long time. And what's a country to do without a healthy workforce? We hear about the Adopt a Clinic initiative, which is brilliant.
It's a brilliant show already.
Brilliant.
And what about the methods of discipline used in our schools? Is it time for an island-wide change? We discuss the implications later on.
Scotia Insurance gives you and us advice on what to get started on before 2018 rolls around.
And find out how donating clothes to children's homes can get you experiencing live and up-close musical performances.
I want to do that, and she's been giving us the style tips from day one. Now, Natalia O is stopping by as a Restaurant Week ambassador, and she's bringing the good folks from Cellar 8 for a taste.
Lovely. Have you been there?
No.
It's fabulous.
Where is it?
It's at Manor Park. Oh. Very nice. Oh, you know, wine. People like you?
Poor people like
me. No, they do. They do.
Marissa,
I'll buy you a drink. Okay. You all right? Arthritis? What is it?
Could be, you know. I have what they call a weak wrist. Okay. So every now and again. And I think because I slept like that.
Yeah. Come here, let me touch you.
No, I'm fine.
No, I have the magic. You don't see all the astrology going on our station,
fine.
The advertisements. I and I have the power to heal. How's it feel, better?
No, not really. We also look at the truth about running injuries with Olympian Ewan Blake and Pilates expert, Summer Lopez. I almost said pilots.
Pilots, Pilates. Latte. And Rocker's Elements continues to bring the music from our Smile Stage band. They will be blessing us this morning.
Yeah, I was just going to say continue.
No, they don't continue. Well, they continue. Well, every Wednesday there's good music, so they'll continue the legacy that Smile has started with bringing good music to our stage this morning. That's the Rocker's Elements. We want you all to stay stay tuned. Put a smile on your face. It's going to be a great day.
All right. Have some time for some hot topics, folks. Actually, it does feel better.
Tell the people. Before you do anything, tell the people, Neville. The people.
It does feel better.
Say Empress Golding.
Golden.
You cured my pain.
You didn't cure it, but it feels better.
What's going on in the hot topics?
All right, the first one says if the Prime Minister has his way, Jamaica will join 59 countries of the world that have banned corporal punishment. And I quote, while it is not a consensus across the aisle or even a consensus with the political parties about banning corporal punishment totally, I wish to declare that I'm totally against corporal punishment, says the Prime Minister. He said the time has come for Parliament to debate the controversial issue in an effort to finally declare an end to corporal punishment within public institutions. Wow. It says immediate support for the Prime Minister's position came from former Education Minister Ronnie Thwaites, who told reporters that no human being should be subject to such abuse. When does it become abuse, even as a parent? When does it become abuse? Because if the great Kush bang this up, now you slap him on the hand and say, don't do that again. That is corporal punishment.
It depends on how you look at it. In some countries, that would be considered corporal punishment. Where do we draw the line is a question, and you know, I am all for, you know, it's not everything that the world does, more follow fashion, as we would say, but I think this is an important conversation. We need to have some measures in place to manage, you know, punishment meted out on our children, because some of it does lead to abuse and it can scar the child and there are lasting effects and there are other ways to discipline. Last night, actually, to share a personal note, last night my son made me so frustrated. And you know, when you get upset as a mom, you want to be like, huh? But then I calmed and I looked at him and I said, son, let me talk to you. I'm going to take away my phone that you borrow in the evening to play games. I'm going to take away, what else did I say I was going to take away? No more TV for a week if you don't listen to what I'm saying. And he was in tears. He was, no, mommy. No, is that abuse? I don't know. But, you know, what I'm saying is the physical punishment is not the only way. Even though it's a part of our culture, it's going to be hard to change. But I will follow my Prime Minister and his lead on that one.
All right, we move on. Hanover Municipal Corporation bans coverage of committee meetings, so the media is not allowed. The Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Gardner, made the declaration yesterday ahead of the sitting of the Physical Planning, Environment and Development Committee. He says the decision to block the coverage followed the backlash over certain comments uttered at the September planning meeting, which were reported in a newspaper article. So in that article, councillors raised concern about a stench emanating from the sewage system at the Grand Palladium Lady Hamilton Hotel and placed the Hanover Health Department on notice. He says, our councillors sometimes say things out of context that should not be said in a meeting, and sometimes they do not realise the implications of the things they say. Well, Mr. Gardner, what do you mean they don't realise the implications of the things that they say?
Boy, I mean, I get it. When you're in a meeting and you're planning out stuff, you may say something and it can...
Yeah, but if you know that the press is there.
Right.
It's not like you don't know the press is there. Right. Then you ought not to say anything. That it's sometimes we talk about having this mic on. Mm-hmm. And every now and again, we get ourselves in hot water because sometimes the mic goes out when it's probably not supposed to. Sometimes, and sometimes we say things. But if I'm on air and I know that I'm speaking like I'm speaking to you now, then I must be held responsible for my utterances. Yeah.
And I guess, I think they should probably have different kinds of meetings.
Well,
but
that's
you're
what he's saying. He said the media will be allowed for the general council meetings, which are held on the second Thursday of each month. All I'm saying, I mean, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do, and I guess it's your prerogative. But all I'm saying is, if you know that the media is there, and obviously the media is there to report on what they hear, then you should be concerned about what you say, because it's going to be in the media.
I think transparency is going to be important here, and you know, there've been some issues in the same parish with nepotism and other things that have hit the press. So we don't know if this is a good idea, looking at the history. Maybe we need to bring in the press and hold them accountable.
Or maybe you should say to the press at this time in the meeting, we don't want you to be covering anything here. I suspect if I'm a journalist and you say that to me, this is off air, off camera, then I either accept or I don't, because I say things to journalists as a football coach. They will come to me and I say, this is between me and you. And they say, okay, and I trust them enough to know that it was between me and them. And even if I go to a coach, I will say, I am speaking to you now as the host, as a journalist, and not my friend. So anything you said to me now.
Yeah, off the record. And
something
the record,
might happen. And I say, why Empress not playing? And him say, boy, I'm Sabel between me and you. So I said, tell me something that I can say on here. Because I cannot say she's not playing like coach, not like that. So I say, well, you were disrespectful or something. Anyway.
West Kingston, Zozo Widens in Denham Town.
Somebody asked me why we keep saying Zozo when it's actually Zoso.
Oh, so did I just say Zozo?
Yeah.
Zoso, I know, right?
I'm not Zoso. Certain, I'm not certain it's the most important thing in life, but my good friend said that.
It's true.
We
it's
all Zoso. Say
we
Zozo.
We all been saying Zozo, the Zoso.
She doesn't like that. So
it's Zoso.
It's Zozo because it's the zone of special operations. So they've expanded. The one in Denham Town, and the boundaries pushed northward from Greenwich Street to Blount Street. It added Denham Town Primary School continues to remain outside the zone. The new border has now pushed the boundary to Albert Street further westward to include Water Lane. And the new western boundary is Little King Street, which I have no idea where Little King Street is. I know where King Street is. I didn't even know that there was a street called Little King Street. Everybody right there. Where is that? Right in front of Maypen Cemetery, that's Little King Street? So, past the Denham Town Station. Yeah, I didn't even know that there was a street
Little
called
King
Little
Street.
King Street.
Yeah. Is Zozo working?
They say it is.
All right.
They say it is. I think the people in Montego Bay were saying that, all right, it's working where you are, but outside of that zone, things are
hot.
There's still mayhem. So I don't know how you control this. But I hate to repeat myself, but I've been saying this for years now. We have to stop this. No Zozo not going to stop it. No minister not going to stop it. No prime minister. We just have to decide one day, say, you know, enough is enough. Make we deal with this thing as an entire group, country. We can't just leave it to them and cuss them when a man gets shot, because we kind of know who's doing it still and we're not saying anything. So, congrats to Jamaica College. Winning the Walker Cup, beating the unbeaten Kingston College 2-1 yesterday. And for the first time, my good friend and coach, Miguel Coley, he's won 4 straight Manning Cup titles. He's won the Olivia Shield. He's won the Super Cup, but he's never won the Walker Cup. Well, now he has that. So congrats, coach, and congrats to your team, JC, and they move on for the Super Cup. And today, later on, right here, we will have Dintil up against Clarendon College in the Ben Francis knockout. So the Walker Cup is the urban area knockout title. Here's the first goal. Tyreek McGee, good finish. That was 1-0. He will come back to score the second one. outstanding young player, outstanding left-footed player. Mm. Jamaica College, massive, having a great time there. So congrats to JC, they win their third. And as I said, Coach Miguel's first. All right, so 114 birthday greetings. The first one, yeah, birthday greetings to Claudette Daly, who works here with us. She celebrates her birthday today. Greetings coming from Miss Dockery and Sonia.
Miss Claudette.
Miss Claudette, oh, is our birthday today. Oh, man.
Pull up your birthdays. Happy birthday, Miss Claudette. Thank you for always looking after us here on A Smile Morning. We appreciate you. And I want to say good morning as well to Miss Dockery.
Yep. Belated birthday greetings to Shari Irving, promotions coordinator from Lasco. It's from Catherine. I think it's Lishon and the marketing team at Lasco. Belated, I said. Suwan, your happy birthday to Kalesha Watson. She's 5 today. There's Kalesha, or Kalisha. It's coming from your mom, your dad, and your godfather, Simon. Hope you have an absolutely brilliant day today. Don't stop. I'm just moving right on.
Move through, brother.
Yeah, please ask Neville to wish my mother, Hazel Veronica Bell Salmon, a happy birthday. Coming from Kenny Salmon and brothers and sisters. Love you, dear mama. And this one says, birthday greetings to Daniel and Anna Deer. Wishing you all the best on your special day from Terry and Jelly and the entire Get There crew. So I suspect this is Anya. Dela, somebody sent this to Dela, and Dela sent it to me. There you go.
Snap it.
That one yet?
Snap the phone.
Yeah, there you go.
Snap.
I don't done. Happy birthday to Robert Brooks, who works at NCP. It's from the family and friends. Happy birthday to Majay Dawkins. Majay, may I have you right here, Tina? Don't move. I have plenty of Majay. Here's Majay. Look how Majay pretty and nice. There you go. Majay Dawkins. She's 4 years old today. She goes to Gentle Kinder Campus from mom, dad, Marsha, and Marlon. There's Majay. Voila. Renee White was yet. Wait, I have a picture for that one. Don't move. I have one more picture to show you. If I can just find it somewhere.
Why?
I don't find this one yet, but it's Renee White was yesterday. Latoya Tingle is today. I have it. Oh, see it here. All right. There you go. All right. So Renee is over here. That's Renee in the black. And that's Latoya Tingle. So Renee was yesterday. Latoya is today. And it's coming from your mom, Lorna Tingle. And I hope you have an absolutely amazing and brilliant day today. Me feel say, me get everything, you know. No? Yeah. And if me not get it, me sorry.
The way true is love.